So you can't do a slasher movie as a TV series. Well,
don't fuck with the original.
Between the movies and the TV series, the Scream franchise is growing every single day, and every generation seems to love it. I recently watched the Scream TV series, and I have opinions on it that are actually pretty positive. However, there are some elements of the TV series that just do not live up to what the movies were. And today we're going to be comparing both the Scream TV series and the Scream movies.
Well, I'm getting ready to watch a video.
Really? What? Like scary movies.
Hello everyone and welcome to Beyond the Mask, where we talk about all things Scream. If you're interested in Scream content or you just like Ghostface in general, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and hit the bell icon to stay alerted for future content. Now, I want to dive right into this video by talking to you about the TV series that was done by MTV. When it was announced, and I announced it was going to be a reboot and the cast was going to be completely different to the movies and they were going to change the Scream mask, I was so skeptical about this show. I had literally no hopes at all that it was going to be anything other than a trashy remake or reboot of a classic film.
Halloween, Texas Chainsaw, Dawn of the Dead, The Hills Have Eyes, Amityville Horror, Last House on the Left, Friday the 13th, A Nightmare on Elm Street, My Bloody Valentine, When a Stranger Calls, Prom Night, Black Christmas, House of Wax, The Fog, Piranha.
Which remakes seem to be a big thing at the moment in Hollywood. But after watching the TV series itself, I actually quite enjoyed it, and I think they did quite a good job at modernising the plot of the Scream movies. But there are some elements of that TV series that I just did not like in comparison to the movies. And I'm going to start off by telling you one of them. Suspense was practically at a zero rate on the TV program. Many of you may actually enjoy what they came to offer, but let me just explain to you my point. When the Scream movies first came out, the initial concept behind the movies was that Ghostface, or the killer, phoned his victims, and the phone call tend to last for quite some time. Initially it would start off quite a basic conversation, but nothing too harmful, that would eventually turn quite sinister as Ghostface would expose what he was actually intending to do. With that in mind, you're watching this character on the phone, which eventually leads to the death, and you know it's going to end one way. Even when it's Sydney, you're never 100% sure how that conversation will end on the phone. I want to draw your attention to the first ever scene of Ghostface calling Casey Becker. That scene lasted for quite some time, but tension was built up purely through the use of dialogue. It was a conversation between two people that eventually turned sinister. There's nothing more dark even today than that moment when Casey Becker realises that this person was actually watching her as he was talking.
You never told me your name.
Why do you want to know my name?
I want to know who I'm looking at.
The TV series, however, seemed to abandon all elements of suspense by, in fact, allowing the killer to just simply text his victims. Texting's fine, it works in a modern world, but it doesn't actually create suspense, and because it doesn't create suspense, it doesn't really create much of a fear factor for the characters. The opening scene of the TV series, in which Nina Patterson was killed, was quite dark and did have a little bit of tension, based on the fact that the killer was stalking her and he was actually showing her that he was doing so. But it still wasn't anything compared to what the original movies had. So the idea that Ghostface is texting his victims just wasn't really something that worked for me. There was phone calls in the TV series, but there wasn't really much in building tension. Occasionally he would call them and initially pretend to be one of the characters, but it just didn't add anything in terms of what the original offered. And I believe that a lot of the horror in the original movies was built up around those phone conversations.
If you hang up on me, you'll die just like your mother.
But moving away from that, another thing that I didn't like about the TV series was that you always felt everybody was too safe. All the cast by the end of series 2, I sat there and I thought, these characters are not going to be killed off, because they all seemed to just limp out of dodge every time they were going to get killed. There was a few scenes in which Brooke was stabbed, attacked, and the killer had so many opportunities to kill her off, but he just never did, because either A, she was contracted to stay on long term, or because it was a TV series, they didn't want to just kill off the core cast members. But that in itself creates no horror for me.
The death of horror right here in front of us.
because in the original movies, nobody was safe. The original cast members could be killed off at any time. Take Randy in Scream 2. He was killed off very, very quick, and quite shockingly so, because he was a survivor of the first movie, and he was the last person that I suspected would die. So the fact that these characters were not able to be killed off, and my brain told me when I was watching it that they would not be killed off, really took away from the suspense for me, because I knew that they were never going to die. There was nobody ever going to lose the life that was part of the main cast. And then when series 2 came, they just started creating a whole new bunch of friends they'd made to kill them off again. Which, yeah, the show does work in that sense, but I just started to just not be afraid of any of the outcomes. And some of the cast members that did die, I was really lacking in caring about them, because I didn't really care enough to be invested that they died in the first place. That's an issue in the Scream movies too, but because the suspense was built up from the phone conversations, it just meant that through those phone conversations, regardless of who it was, you were still terrified for those characters. Another reason the TV series fell flat was something that I mentioned at the start, and I am going to bring it up in this video. The mask situation really bothered me, because that show could have been called anything. It could have been called Slasher. It could have been labelled anything aside from Scream, and it would have still worked, because that mask was nothing connected to Scream itself. And yeah, I know the phone calls and the texting was very Scream related, but it wasn't really in the terms of what the Scream movies set. And for me, I just felt that, you know, they could have used the original mask. The mask itself was iconic and very recognisable as being part of Scream. In fact, it's the face of Scream. So the fact that they didn't use it at all just sort of alienated the show to try and survive with everything being brand new. And that just did not work, hence why the show is no longer on air. But what do you guys think of the TV series? I did enjoy it. I watched all the show through. It was pretty good, and it was quite binge-worthy as well, because I do like slasher films. But as a Scream series, the only thing you can compare it to is the movies, and for me, it really didn't hold up. But what did you guys think? Did some of you prefer the TV series to the movies? I really want to know what you thought, so don't forget to comment below and let me know. Thanks very much for watching again, guys, and don't forget you can still hit me on Facebook, Instagram and Twitter, and don't forget to like this video, it really helps me out a lot. And never, ever, ever forget the very important rule, and that rule is...
You can't do a slasher movie as a TV series.
Like scary.